our two flights have opened the lid on a new type of work, which is really to assess oil and gas activities, emissions of greenhouse gases, air pollutants, and air toxics. So in the papers that has just been published, we try to understand, based on atmospheric measurements, what emissions of various hydrocarbons are in a region that's producing oil and natural gas just north of Denver. It's a region where we conduct long-term measurements, and we have seen in the atmosphere markers of natural gas, and we just wanted to take it a step further and try to quantify, based on measurements, what the emissions are, and then compare those estimates with what the state calculates and produces in an inventory of these emissions.
We look at both the oil and gas production as well as ranching that we see out here, power plants. We will fly loops around them all trying to figure out how much is coming from each one, sort of to partition the sources. So the airplane has been modified. We have three air inlets on the wing. We have a temperature and humidity probe.
And we document the methane levels upwind of the region and downwind of it. And we compute for a flight with the perfect meteorological conditions, or close to perfect, we calculate how much methane is coming in the region and how much methane is coming out of the region. And based on the difference between what's coming out and what came in, we get an estimate of how much was emitted within the region. During the 12 flights that we conducted in the region, we also collected over 100 air samples in glass flasks. These flasks were analyzed in our NOAA Boulder lab for 50 different species. Some of them are volatile organic compounds that can contribute to ozone pollution in the summertime. And this region has been non-attainment for ozone in the summertime since 2007. So we have three main findings. The first one is on methane. Methane is a potent greenhouse gas, more potent than CO2, and it's the main component of natural gas. What we find based on our measurement is that the methane emissions in these regions for just the oil and gas sector are close to three times larger than estimates based on EPA statistics. The VOC emissions from oil and gas activities are at least a factor of two larger than what the state inventory predicts. So we also measure benzene in our discrete air samples at the NOAA Boulder Lab. Some of the benzene correlates well with traces of combustion and traffic emissions. And another piece of the benzene correlates really well with propane, which is a great marker for natural gas. And what we find is that those benzene emissions from oil and gas activities are much larger, a factor of seven larger, than an official estimate that the state of Colorado gave us. These discrepancies are large enough that we need to understand these sources better. It's critical that we work also more closely with the industry to have them help us understand if the 2 days we were out doing our mass balance flights and derivation were representative of a larger time period. More work will happen this summer. There's going to be a lot of scientists in the field here in the Front Range of Colorado to look at various aspects of air quality. Mm. And the goal is really to understand them better, to mitigate them better. I mean, I think what was amazing in this research is that we brought a lot of NOAA together. We had people doing wind measurements from the Physical Sciences Division. We had people from the Chemical Sciences Division advising us on a lot of the mass balance technique and the air quality impacts of our research. And we have the Global Monitoring Division providing all these very high quality calibrated measurements of various species and a context, a broader, larger global context for our very regional study.